Hello, my name is Swarizi. Welcome back to Market Mondays. I work for the Llama Labs ecosystem as a technical analyst slash educator. Inside Llamaverse, I provide consensus on the stock market and crypto markets fully based on technical analysis. I also currently help with the production of Gosu tools. I have a 6-year day trading background with a degree in data analytics, and I'm here to show you how higher highs and lower lows can make a difference inside the price action. First up, we got Bitcoin, and we're going to go over the range-bound zone that we're stuck within from the last 2 weeks. So pushing that 18.5 to about 15.5, this is the zone that we've actually been stuck within, and we're looking for an accumulation within inside this range. And one of the main factors that we're going to be going over today is the lower lows and the higher highs. So right now, let's go over the lower lows. Currently, if we actually draw this smaller intermediate triangle formation, we actually did get the breakdown of our actual triangle formation, which would actually create a lower low inside of this vicinity. But if we're looking at a bigger picture, technically, notice our lows are still higher than the prior ones before, thus giving us some type of upward trend line. Even though it's very faint, it is still there. Which is not giving us lower lows that we're actually looking for. Same thing with the highs. Notice our highs are actually not breaking out. We're not getting higher highs from the last ones. We're actually getting lower highs from each individual candlestick. So this is giving us an indication that, again, we're stuck within this range-bound zone. But when we actually get to either one of our range-bound zones, either our top portion or our bottom portion, like we are near now, we are looking for a lower low or looking for a higher high for the potential breakout of the range. So, as of right now, we're not getting that breakdown for the lower low as of yet. In order to actually get the full breakdown, we'd be looking for a full candlestick that would be breaking through our last low, as opposed to just a wick that would be happening here. We truly want to see the body of the candlestick close beneath our range, thus would give us the indication that we're looking for a 100% move to the downside. Again, looking for that lower low. On the opposite direction, if we happen to get buyers coming in near this support zone and we actually start breaking out of this little range here, we're looking for a retest of our monthly level, and if we can hold that, again, we're looking for another retest of our monthly level, which would give us the indication to see, are we going to be creating higher highs at this point? And that would be able to be seen with this intermediate channel that we're drawing now. As long as we don't break beneath our last low, then again, this fits in line with the accumulation that we're looking for. All right, so next up, we're going to go over Ethereum. And we're going to go over pretty much the same situation. We did have our monthly range that we're playing within, 1420 to 1281 to 1110, and still sitting within the range bound zone that we're playing within. And let's actually draw out that same triangle formation that we had with the rejection of our monthly level. And again, seeing that we are now touching the bottom monthly level, but just like with Bitcoin, we are still holding that intermediate trend. Again, it's very faint, but this low as of right now is not as low as the last low that we initially had. So, thus indicating that we are not getting the breakdown of the lower low as of yet. We are holding the monthly level. And again, holding above the last low, thus creating a higher low. And again, same thing, noticing the lower highs up top with us not getting the breakout. In this situation, we're just forming a bigger triangle formation, which should put us in line to get us to an apex point to either get a breakout to one direction, whether that's to the upside to retest our monthly level, or to get the true breakdown of our monthly level plus our last low, which once we break out of the range, we're looking for a 100% move to the downside or to whichever direction that we're breaking out of that actual range. So, again, watching the higher highs potentially being formed here, if we can actually break out of this trend channel, then that would be insinuating the higher highs. But not initially for the major range that we're looking for within the last 2 weeks. This would just put us back into the accumulation zone that we've actually been looking for since last week. So again, making sure that you're looking at the candlestick closes. If you can see the body close beneath or above whichever range bound zone that you're looking at, can give you a major indication of future price action and how that's actually going to react and how far that can actually run in either direction that you're taking it. So again, if we're looking for a breakout of the major range, we're looking for 100% move. 100% is the size of the actual range that we're playing within. So from that 1420 to about 1110, that range bound zone is very big for us to take a look at, especially with the candlestick formations that we're going to be seeing. So again, as of right now, if we're looking for the breakdown, we must see the body actually close beneath the last low. If we're looking for the breakout for higher highs, then we're actually looking for volume to actually come in and truly break out of all the monthly zones that we're looking at. So this intermediate trend line, this monthly zone, and our top range as well. So watching the candlestick bodies is going to be huge. Just because a wick goes over or under doesn't mean that we're actually going to head in that direction. So make sure that we're looking at the bodies of the candlesticks as opposed to the wicks, because they can be very deceiving. So that's going to be it for this week's Market Mondays. Make sure you're drawing your ranges and also watch the candlesticks close, because again, this can give a major indication of future price action and where that will be headed. So you guys stay safe, and I'll catch you guys next week, Market Mondays.